headliner op de mainstage op dag 1 van Pukkelpop. Je ziet hier ondertussen twee vijfde naast mij staan van Editors. Guys, first of all, thank you very much for coming over.
Cheers.
You've just did South Africa for the very first time over a course of 900 different shows. Must feel exciting.
Yeah, I think we hit our 900th show in Cape Town, actually. Yeah, it's incredible. I mean, to go to a place that we've never been to before. Luckily, on this campaign, we've done that a few times. There's still festivals that even we haven't played before, and luckily we're being invited to them at this stage in our career. It's great.
Do you go to those festivals that you visit for the very first time with some expectations as well?
I think Africa, we couldn't really have any expectations because we didn't really know anything of what it was going to be like. And to be honest, we were blown away by Oppie Coppie Festival.
Yeah.
It was literally in the bush. In the middle of South Africa, near Botswana, it was insane.
But it was warm as well.
No, it's winter. It's
it was
quite
winter.
Cold.
Yeah, it's kind of this sort of weather.
It's good. But yeah, it's a remarkable place.
Now let's talk music. The Weight of Your Love got released last year. It's some more than 1 year actually been released.
Yeah.
Did the songs start living their own lives as well?
Oh, definitely.
Because it mostly happens on tour that, you know, you start playing them and you start adjusting them a little bit.
Oh, definitely. I mean, you know, as soon as you go out with a new record, it does take us and the fans a time to get used to the new songs.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I think the set we're playing at the minute is very much a mixture of all the four albums that we've got. And, you know, I think there's spikes in that set that we prefer on the new record, you know, because it's what we've been working on as this band as well.
We've seen, I think, in this summer of festivals, the reaction changed from last summer when the songs were new. Everyone's kind of bedded into the songs a lot more now, so there's a massive warmth to the newer songs, and it kind of fits it all in with the older songs. So
actually playing them after a year, everybody's known.
Yeah, because they're old now. They're just, you know, they're in the same pile as the other songs.
Now, Justin, you joined 2 years ago. Were you also able to put your own stamp on the older songs from Editors?
Yeah, I mean, when I came in, I was conscious that they didn't want a replacement. And to be honest, I'm not that great a guitarist, so it'd be like,
oh, so
you just play. You just play as you play, and no two guitarists are the same, I don't think. So it was one of those, just get in and do it and press all the pedals until it sounds about right.
Do you focus on particular things within the tracks themselves to adjust them a little bit to your own, you know?
Yeah, I just play.
I think you just know what you like doing, you know.
Yeah.
You don't want to, he doesn't want to just replicate what's gone on. And I mean, of course, there are moments in our songs that people want to hear, you know. Stuff like Munich or something. You've got to play that.
I don't want to be the bad guy who plays it in a. You know, I don't want to be that guy.
Yeah.
So you got to play.
So Justin, you've ruined that song.
Yeah. So you got to play it pretty straight on some of the like the big like calling card riffs, and they're great riffs. So it's not like I'm going in and playing some really rubbish riffs. It's like I'm playing massive riffs. So.
Okay.
You know.
One of the last videos that I saw was Sugar.
Yeah.
That got taped in Belgium.
Yeah.
First of all, why Belgium? What's the story behind the video clip and? Justin, are you more involved into the video thing as well, since you're like one of the two masterminds behind the Handheld Cine Club?
I do.
Mastermind,
that's a good one. That. Remember that one.
I will.
The Sugar video was just a great treatment that came from a Belgian director, and it's hard when, especially because I do treatments for other bands and make videos for other bands. When I see treatments coming in for this band, I have to kind of take myself away from it because. Not as a conflict of interest, but you can tell what's going to happen in what people write in treatments to what actually happens in the video. And this one was like a really solid, this is going to look really cool kind of video. So
it's a weird one, exactly.
Yeah, it's really weird.
So how did they actually pitch it to you? It's like, we're going to do some weird
stuff?
That's
what interests us. I mean, there's tons of videos that come through that feel like they're written for a different track, you know, not they're like, oh, do they just pull them off the shelf for for somebody else and they've just bunged it into the pile. But this one, that claustrophobic nature of the song, and it just had enough aggression to it that we were interested straight away.
And there's wires involved.
Yeah, there's a hang. Justin got to hang up on some wires.
Yeah.
It was pretty fantastic.
It's a new experience. It's good.
Now, for you, Justin, while killing time while being on tour, you've taken a lot of pictures lately of airplanes.
Yeah.
You're gonna make some kind of a collection out of it.
You know, I was actually thinking about doing that and making a little print out of it because it's. It's like, I guess it's like an alternative tour poster. I've got a picture of everywhere we've been on this record. Anything to do with this record, I've got a picture of it. I was actually thinking of making a little print
So like keeping memory or keeping track of where you visited.
I just want to put it all in a big like square. Has to be squares.
That means you have the little snap.
Big, big print with a square for each day we spent on tour.
So you don't have to write anything particular about that day or about that venue.
No.
That's an easy one.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for stopping by, Ed Justin. Thanks, guys.
Cheers.